treachery is to be slain on sight.
And spare the citizen.
Those were Imperial dragoons. What's going on?
Let's go and see.
Right. But first we find Goots.
I just hope he's all right.
Yourself.
Do we have to?
Stay down!
Come on.
be glad to fall into a sewer.
May my blade strike true.
It's over!
Ward secured, Captain. None of the empty forces remain. They gather the men. We press on to the council chambers.
Yes, Captain.
What of the men and women in the market district? The evacuation is complete, Captain.
Good.
Then all that remains is to dethrone the protector.
There it is. The bell tower.
Right. Let's go. Goods lift.
Where in Grigor's name did you come from?
Damn it. We'll have to find a way around.
On the ramparts!
Kill them!
Thank you.
Can you see him anywhere?
Love. Over here, Clive! Are you all right?
Good. There you are.
I didn't know there'd be a dragon.
All right. Let's get out of here.
Oh!
What now?
Is that Mother Crystal's heart?
What the hell is it doing up there?
Do this.
We must leave. Now, Your Grace, I beg of you.
This is not what he wanted. Something's happened. Forgive me, Yod, but I must put a stop to this.
Your Grace!
So, what do we do now, then?
We destroy the heart.
But he might come back!
As soon as the flames die down, the Imperials and the Dalmechs will move in. This may be our only chance.
And Bahamut has gone for now. You should get as far away as you can, Goots.
What? And leave you slot in the ledge?
I can't do that.
If you're staying, then so am I. I packed everything up before I made a run for it, so if there's out you need, just ask. But I won't be giving it away for free. Nana'd never forgive us if I did.
Thank you, Goot.
His need out. You want us to make you something? Is all done then? No. Here you go. Is there else you need? All done then. Good luck, Clive.
Drake's tail is right.
I might need.
Of course.
You be brave now.
Drake's tech.
Oh, but remember.
And I dare say we'll be. No more roads.
We'll have to find our own path.
Do you feel that, Clive?
Ether. Just what we need. Another flood.
It's already turned to.
There's no reason to hold back.
Come on. Should we?
Ah!
Are those the council chambers? How are they still standing?
I don't know.
He'll be all right, Clive. He's a survivor.
We're getting close.
I don't care what it wants.
Neither do I.
Fire and flame!
Already.
These beasts. They're getting stronger.
We can think about them later.
Right now, there's only one thing we need to focus on.
The heart.
We might be able to get up through the building.
It's worth a try.
Quiet. There's someone up there.
Is someone there?
Mother.
It's you. Tried to take him from me. Oh, my boy. My darling. Darling boy.
Is this the child you made with the Emperor? Why, Mother? Why did you betray us all?
You have no right!
Answer him.
We took you in, savage. Show some respect for those who raised you. Honorable Elwyn, always thinking of his precious homeland. But what worth is a homeland in a world beset by the Blight?
Father did not seek to protect his country. He sought to protect his people.
A leader's duty is not to protect his people. It is to protect the source of his sovereignty. The noble blood that runs in his family's veins. So long as this bloodline remains unbroken, what does it matter if a nation falls? One can always found another. Unlike him, I did my duty. I preserved my line. I bore a son of the noblest blood to whom the whole world might kneel. That is why I gave Rosaria to Sambrek, that I might join my line with the Lesages and birth a savior of this benighted land, blessed by both Bahamut and the Phoenix!
You sold your country for a child.
Why did he need another? You had Joshua.
I had nothing. You were always your father's son, so very strong and bold and daring, and yet you failed to awaken. Would that Joshua had been granted a tenth of your strength. Oh! How the nobles laughed that Elwyn's firstborn was surely the son of a concubine, and my own, not long for this world. The shame of it! The shame of being slandered by one's inferiors! How could you ever know how that feels? It should have been you! Why didn't the Phoenix choose you?
Joshua's every waking moment was spent trying to shoulder the burden that you and the Phoenix and the Duchy foisted on him. That's why I became his shield! To help bear the weight! But what did you do? You betrayed your own blood and surrendered your son to his fate!
Joshua, my darling boy. I never meant to hurt him. The soldiers' orders were clear. He was to be spared. Why did you survive when the only one I truly cared for died?
What? Have you not looked out of the window? Joshua is here! The Phoenix lives on! He's battling Bahamut as we speak! Joshua! Wake up! I I'm a shield of Rosaria. And I will do my duty.
What are you...
Thank you.
finish him!
Don't do this! Prince, get behind me!
If you're sure.
This is drinking me.
We have to stop him.
Clive.
We can. And we will. Together.
to match such power?
By trusting in our own.
the world.
Not today. Come on, Joshua!
Clive!
My brother.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You're alive. We both are. Nothing else matters. I never dared hope that I would see this day.
Reunited at last.
Jill!
It is done. The demon that would tear our house apart is no more. Father.
The Mother Crystal. It's collapsing.
Right. We need to leave.
No. Wait. I owe him a debt.
Fine.
You there.
I just read on the quote section.
Don't reinforce the walls.
Report, Captain.
It could be the fires have spread.
Can nothing be done to call them off?
I regret not, Your Radiance. The Dragoons answer to none but His Imperial Highness. The Council is powerless to intervene.
We're hearing reports of rebel
madness is this, Theon.
Throughout the neighboring district.
Focus all efforts on extinguishing the fires around the capital. The city can wait.
Don't dally, man! Go!
Your Radiance.
And I want you to find out
the
Dalmec's movements.
By the light! Dion, have you taken leave of your senses? Call off the Dragoons at once!
Fear not. The populace will come to no harm at their hands. I am here to save you, Father.
Save me?
A creeping darkness hides in the heart of Sanbrek. It stems from your wife, the traitorous Annabella.
Not another word, Dion.
Father, though you may not see it, the darkness has taken hold of you. It has made you forget yourself. But I bid you remember, there was a time when you ruled not with cruelty, but with compassion. Why now do you turn your back on your people? Why now do you seek to stoke the fires of war? You too have borne witness to this change, Your Eminences. And you know, as well as I, who is responsible for it. A puppet now sits upon the throne. But cut his strings, and the Master loses her power!
What?
Dion, you bear steel before your Emperor?
Guards! Take him!
For every citizen who falls, another can be bred. For every home that burns, another can be built. Those were your words. But when the last of your citizens has fallen, and all of their homes have been reduced to ash, what will become of your empire, of its rulers, of your god? As the Mother Crystals crumble one by one, and the Blight sweeps in to claim all that we hold dear, our people look to their Emperor for protection. Yet he labors not to secure their futures, but to seize what is left of the Twins for himself! Even if it should come at the cost of everything his loyal citizens have labored to build!
Dion, you must understand.
A small price to pay, is it not? You've been blessed with great power, Dion. Enough to win me the world. So go, claim Valestia for me, brother.
Dion.
Father, how he doted on his children. That he would die to protect me was plain. It was but a matter of when.
You planned this?
You did well to endure so long. But you broke in the end, as I knew you would. And now Muthos approaches. Put him to the proof. I would see if he breaks. Go, Bahamut. Kinslayer.
You cannot stay here, Mother. Come. Take my hand.
Get away from me! This is all just a dream, just a bad dream! You will not take me, Shadow! You will not take me!
Mother.
If it is consciousness that weaves your wills together, consciousness that blurs the boundary between your own will and that of others, then we shall set you apart once more. The ties that bind you shall be severed. And humanity returned to its proper place. By primogenesis shall a new age of reason begin.
Relax, Your Majesty. Don't you want to play? It's been a long time.
If that is your wish.
Men, you are as meek as all the others.
Such feeble creatures. Gifted the power of icons, yet slaves to fickle emotions, usher you to your doom. And so you bind your fragile wills with strands of consciousness.
The wretched handiwork of a wretched people.
The Sons of Fire were united at last, and for but a moment, their flame burned bright. Soon, Muthos shall become our perfect vessel.
And then shall the world be remade.
Not before the bonds are severed of trust, of respect, of love. Only when every strand of consciousness is cut away may Muthos return to our side. By primogenesis shall all be undone. Mankind shall be rid of his wretchedness, and Muthos of his will. But while he yet clings to it, he has the power to forge bonds anew. And so we bid you. Find Muthos, and sever everyone.
To destroy that which has no physical form, you ask the impossible.
There is nothing your black blade cannot cut, Odin. We shall unite with Muthos, and bring forth a new world. So long as our vessel remains unclaimed by humanity.
It shall be done, Master. My will is yours.
How is your brother?
Asleep since I returned from the Dominion. Tyr says he should be back on his feet soon enough. For a while, at least. She discovered something on his chest. A swelling, circled in stone.
The curse. For every mountain we climb, another rises up to greet us, doesn't it?
It's never ending. Even the sky Seems to have grown tired of it all. If I disturb them.
Joshua. While he rests, I might as well see what Otto has to say.
See the pair that got hauled into tires?
Aye. All their fancy silks stained red.
Thanks for not leaving me in the Dominion. If you hadn't come back, I might still be stuck there.
Still alive, are you? If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. Is that all? Clive. The whole realm's in chaos. But as the old saying goes... Take care.
Disguise. Unless that is.
What's that for you, dear?
No scratches, right? That it? Fine.
Since the sky started boiling.
A few more days without a visit and we'll have to start eating the blankets.
Tell me you saw that.
Clive. What is it that you wish to learn?
wasn't expecting you back so soon. It's not true. We've lost so much. Is everything we've received and everything promised? All done?
Otto, the realm, as long as you look past the fat storms at Mother Crystals and the skies are a roiling cesspit. He's with your uncle in the Free Cities, helping Mid with her project. Sent an owl their way the moment the winds turned foul. Still waiting on a reply, though.
Do you have any good news?
Well, that depends.
All right, fine. What do you suggest?
Oh, no, I'm just the messenger. Could be that Lady Vivian and Old Tomes have their own soul. Could be that the...
I suppose.
I see that every report that comes my way makes it into the hands of both Lady Vivian and the Lord. If anyone can tell you what might be barreling down the mountain towards us.
How is it that every one of your little excursions presages some inexplicable... Not that you are to blame for the Dominion's fate.
I'm sorry, Ike.
My countrymen are stronger than you think. A few toppled clock towers won't break their spirits. They'll be back on their feet in no time.
I hope so.
Look at us. Bluer than a pair of bog crabs. Tempting though it may be.
You believe there's one?
I don't know.
Beneath these darkened skies, fear and confusion reign over Valisthea. Oh, the lands around the fallen Mother Crystals had already begun to wilt for want of ether. But not like this. Crystals that filled wells and fueled furnaces, now nothing but pretty shards of rock. And those that hang from the people's necks cast nary a glimmer of light to keep the dark at bay. It is only a matter of time before the common folk convince themselves that the end of days is upon us. Yet I fear a swift end is more than we can hope for. While most of the world thirsts for ether, the remainder drowns in it, spawning Akashic in droves. And amidst the hordes of mindless beasts, with magics as like to fail as function, even the strongest nation would falter. Rosaria and the Iron Kingdom teeter on the brink of collapse, while the tragedy in Twinside has all but paralyzed the Holy Empire. Dalmechia fares little better. Rumor has it the ministers fled the capital after the fall of Drake's Fang, leaving their beloved republic to crumble. Walud, meanwhile, moves in earnest. The Einherjar has been sighted off Storm. The world, in short, is in chaos. It would seem our civilization was nothing but a castle of sand. To be washed away at the whim of the waves.
A castle of sand.
Not my best flourish, but it seemed fitting. The reports I've received are considerably more without the protection of their nations, it will defending a farmhouse against a band of chocobo. But pitchforks and palisades will do little to stop. Should the King of Walu deign to invade?
See the sun again?
Sid, did you know that chocobos are far more resilient to the effects of ether than most other beasts? Some say that's one of the reasons they were tamed for use as mounts and sumpters, so that an ether flood wouldn't mean instant death for their riders or drivers. Me, I reckon they built it up over generations. Too many foolish traders driving their birds into floods, and only the toughest surviving.
Guess. You're here about the skies.
Is there anything you don't know, Lawsman?
It doesn't take a court astrologer to augur the obvious. As for what has disturbed the heavens, that, I believe, is a question the Fallen might be better placed to answer than I. And on the sixth day, did the gods tear the sun from the firmament, visiting darkness upon their prideful sons and daughters? But I dare say you remember your childhood lessons.
You think they're connected?
Well, he has certain...
There is nothing to...
But he wouldn't be the first god of whom that could be said. Yet for all the fairy tale, had I the journal of Moss the Chronicler, you will forget...
Certainly not. Even without this journal, you've provided us ample.
Perhaps Otto will be more inclined to share his thoughts when he hears what the others had to say.
I was wondering when next you'd visit, with the darkenings. But be that as it may, I have a few new notes that might interest you. You wish to study the tomes? The door to the shelves shall ever be open.
Only one.
It would. We had as many owls arrive while you were at the shelves. Martha's got Akashic at her gates, and talk of monsters roaming the hills outside.
And don't forget Dalimil.
When it
fucking pours. The curse breakers are spread. And even if I could get word to what which means...
Jill and I.
Let them know we're on up.
Fancy a look at the list, do you?
I don't mean to be gloomy. They need all the help.
Here you go.
Seen enough?
That's better.
Thank you.
safe.
Akashic attacked us out of the blue, and there's no telling when they might be back. You best keep that sword handy, Sid.
This man's gonna die if we don't get him to a healer.
Martha, it's good to see you.
And you, Clive. Jill?
Otto said you'd been attacked by Akashic. What exactly happened here?
Those skies are what happened. Not long after they fell dark, we had our first visit. There were hundreds of them. Tried to storm the hill. Only a handful made it up here, but that was more than enough. The rest are still down there now.
What do you think?
That we join the...
I thought you... Now, where I need you is the... Let the men know you've come to help.
We're on our way.
They were too fast.
Do you think there were as many as Martha says?
Stop that.
More.
If they ain't clawing...
Gates are climbing up the cliffs near the lift.
You don't think they've abandoned us, do you?
Barricades we've set up around the town won't hold the Akashic back for long.
Clive, wounded.
Deal with the Akashic first.
Too slow.
These men don't have the look of hired swords.
If you've come to...
You are mistaken. We're here by Matt.
How do you know my...
Forgive me, my lord.
Wade's men? Where is your command?
Sir Wade left earlier with a...
Did he? Take your wounded Martha...
And to think you took them for thieves.
When did Wade?
Not long after Rosalith fell. The Guardians asked me to shelter some of them that had lost their homes. They were making ready to leave just as the skies turned. And we agreed it was best...
Martha! The scouting party's almost at the lift. Are they...
Damn it all.
We'll worry about...
You look after everyone.
I will.
dog.
Squire, I need you to get those who can still walk, but what about... I didn't, sir.
Sir Wade.
Lord Rossfield.
Martha seemed to think you might need some, and by the look...
We thought, but we didn't know there would be...
Behind you!
Damn it! We need to get the injured to safety.
Do you think we can hold them off?
We can certainly try. Are you with us, Sir Wade?
Always.
Then let's do our duty.
Is anyone hurt?
I don't...
And yet again...
You've no...
I see you're...
Martha!
Is something wrong?
The lookout saw smoke coming from...
A second...
Feel like...
Always.
Jill and I will make fee. You'll need to move...
Don't you worry...
The moment my...
Sharp as razors, my blades are.
fiends trying to climb the walls here, too.
They're headed for the rest.
We have to slow them down. Martha and the others won't be ready.
Something's coming.
Apologies, my lord. Did I miss anything?
Only the first round, Sir Wade. Shall we? Do you see any more?
No. I think that was the last of them.
But it won't be long before the next lot arrive.
Then we make for Martha's while we can.
What did you find out there?
The same as Sir Wade.
Well, wherever they came from, hopefully we'll have enough to...
How many of you...
Oh, damn...
It was a hard-fought victory. It's not a matter of if the Horde will be back. The inn here affords a good view.
What do you say, Ma?
Well...
My lord, there's someone I'd like... Oscar?
Who It is an... I am Oscar.
Murdoch.
Oh, he didn't. But his brother...
Well, go on then.
Yes. If it pleased you, my Lord Marquis, I would learn the duties of...
But I am a shield no longer, and spending time in the company of an...
My Aunt Hannah once told me, you have accomplished much since taking on them, and I would sooner serve... not that Sir Wade and the other guardian...
It's all right. There is only so much that...
But a squire...
Would that really... You were a squire once?
I would not have it any... I will not let you down, Lord Rossfield. You or my uncle.
We shall be staying here for the time being, and not...
You lost, stranger. Wherever you're headed.
Ambrosia won't help me here. To ride from here.
Another God's forsaken soul, eh? Only those who have nothing. Show him to your pockets. Your brothers will break!
It's like...
Yeah.
deserter turned outlaw. Never more similar than he knew.
Thank you. That's it. Should I be where?
Jill.
Hola.
Your Stolas said that Dalamil has...
Indeed.
Any idea what...
But the fact...
What did you...
As if by magic. Let's just say we've... And at this rate, it won't be the actions of the... I've tried reasoning with a dis...
Perhaps we could...
What makes you think?
What makes you think?
She makes a fair point, Sid.
Suppose we just follow the shouting. Poor bastard. Couldn't run because of the weight of his load. Still, better a branded than one of us.
You wouldn't talk like that if it had been your men whose throats were slit. We hire mercenaries and have them mount-
And what happens when those mercenaries are slaughtered like your men? Are you- We're better off using that coin to buy food and some- And you cannot, Phil.
But what happens when they come back?
That's enough. Both any more of this and I'll come back when you're ready.
Victor. What's he doing here?
Sid.
I was about to ask you.
Kostnis is in chaos. And the market, the Briar's Kiss here in Dalamil, is the only place I can reliably obtain. So I was here to do just that when Master Lubor told me of his troubles. He thought I might be able to talk some sense into these fools. But if you're here, I suppose his patience must be...
Who are those people?
Those were the thorns in Lubor's side. These are cursed skies. Or an entire...
We're still working on that. Perhaps we can find a solution.
I hope so.
Poor bastard.
So, you see my predicament?
What I saw was a room full of people who were... But if left to smolder...
My thoughts are... Both sides wish to protect their homes and livelihoods.
And if there's one thing that...
What would Sid...
Well... He'd let them choose for themselves.
That sounds like a
A recipe for disaster is precisely what it is. But... Perhaps that realization would be enough to make them question the ingredient. While it's plain neither Conrad nor... It may still be possible... before presenting them with a third option.
And that would be?
To pool our resources and save the city ourselves. Why fight each other?
When all that fear and anger can be directed at the bandits.
It appears we have a plan of action. Victor, pay Conrad a visit. See if you can't convince him of his folly. I'll speak with...
As you wish.
Don't worry, Victor and I will do...
Play along.
What he means to say is yes.
Picture it, Conrad. Your own city guard. With you as captain.
Me.
Next thing you know, Natalie'd be off in the bandit's bedroom
floor. Buy more supplies. We might as well scatter seeds near a rat's nest. There.
Conrad. May I introduce you?
A pleasure, my lady.
The pleasure is all mine.
As I told you, I summoned the commander here from Canver to inquire about a contract.
Victor says you told him no. That there aren't any men left to hire. Is that true?
True as the crystals cracked. Nobles came and claimed every last one worth his salt. And not just from us Redwings. You know of the 7 high houses. There must be 20 swords assigned each one. Granted, we have a few boys left. If it's boys you're looking for.
Well, Conrad? Are you saying that Dalamil's finest cannot defend this town better than a gaggle of unblooded striplings? That a band of beardless youths could better avenge the deaths of your brave men than you?
Absolutely not. We'll show those
I can't believe—
Conrad's not what you call— And there's a reason why I had you do the talk.
I wonder if Conrad has the right of it.
If you're wondering why Dalamil's in such a sorry state, you can blame my shot.
If I had my pickaxe, I would have.
I mean, it may still be possible to buy something.
All this after the last cell souls we paid for proved themselves such reliable souls. You never throw good gill after bad.
Never poke a hornet's nest, they say. Comrade's going to get us all.
Ah, here he is, Natalie. Allow me to introduce Lord Underhill of Randalar's prestigious League of Mer.
Underhill.
I was just telling the good lady of our conversation, my lord, and how you were lamenting the state of the capital's stores.
Lubor says that not only are the granaries almost empty, but that war and the blight mean this season's harvest won't be enough to fill them for winter.
Indeed, certainly that is the case. The nobles in the capital are buying up the city's stock. It is only a matter of—
It is worse, and while I applaud your endeavors to dissuade our more bellicose citizens from seeking vengeance, I sense Conrad is not wrong in his assessment of the bandits, which means that now, more if our humble town is to endure.
All right.
But you needn't have gone through.
Thank you, Clive.
She saw right.
I didn't say it was good. Now, my scouts should be returning shortly. Meet me back at the Briar's Kiss, and we shall see what we face.
I'm not convinced our roles in this ruse were entirely necessary.
I don't know. Conrad seemed quite taken with you.
I would not see any unnecessary.
There's truly no chance for us to restock our supplies.
Mummy, I'm scared.
Oh, I'm ruined.
Good news. Both Conrad and Natalie with time.
Time no longer appears.
I take it your scout.
Technically, it would be the bandits who found my scout. Or.
You're not sick.
They don't just want food.
I have a fate. I'm told the bandits march in two groups. One
very well.
The rest, my friend. Mistakes, I concede, are high. But if this.
That is a lot of faith to put into those who had.
Then it will be for us.
I thought you.
We'll hold them off.
And we.
The women folk have come to us.
I'll take that one.
He's all yours.
Overwhelm us.
the townspeople.
I don't hear any.
That we should have.
Natalie, you did well out there.
Without you, you saved...
We all...
Conrad seems...
I'd say...
I... The plan worked, Sid. Granted, it only took an... Come now, Vic. We are you... As for you, Sid...
I'll take...
To swim.
We'd be fine in our village, but then the Scottish...
The Imperials promptly quit their posts once word of Dominion's fall came. Lord Rosfield hired us not long after to see the refugees safely inside and make certain those who now want in, get in.
Ambrosia won't help me here.
Ready, go?
Thank you.
Mistakes. That'll do, girl.
So Cid rides to the rescue once more. We're in your debt. Well,
And some of your numbers serve to shield.
You're a devil with a blade and no mistake.
It seems this one has a little more life left in it. All right, then.
Thank you. finished.
First, we find Isabel.
Heard a bloke saying he saw ghosts on the far side of the wall.
And what can I do for you? An excellent choice. You've a keen eye. I'll be here if you need me. Will it be today? Allow me to educate you. Very good. Back again? Then how could it not? But are we any... I cannot claim... Such ironic, then. I cannot claim... Such are the wages. Ironic, then. Should I learn aught else?
Not much more to say, is there? Our friends are in need.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Your benefactors are a generous lot. All yours. Best of luck out there, Sid.
What did you find?